Squash bee natural history. There are an estimated 4,000 species of bees native to North America, and research has shown that they pollinate many of the crops that we grow. One of these important crop pollinators is this bee, which is called Peponapis pruinosa. It's also known as the squash bee. The squash bee, as its name suggests, is a specialist bee that relies on squash, pumpkins, and some gourds. These are all plants in the genus Cucurbita. These plants produce female flowers, which provide nectar that fuels the flight of bees, and male flowers, which in addition to nectar, produce pollen grains. Now, pollen grains are full of protein and fat and are what female squash bees are actively collecting to bring back to their nests to feed their young. In this picture, you can see how the pollen grains cling to the hairy bodies of the bees, and they'll use their long tongues to reach the nectar at the base of the flower. Now, when we think about bees, we typically think about this bee, which is the European honeybee. This bee lives in large social colonies, which we manage and trek around the country to pollinate our crops. But squash bees live a very different kind of life, and because they are ground nesting bees, actually spend most of their life underground. Here we have an adult female squash bee. In the early summer, she'll emerge from the ground and maybe start looking for a flower to fuel up on some nectar. At some point, a male will mate with her and then fly off to look for more females. Mated females will look for a good spot to put their nest. Now, we don't know exactly how they decide where to nest, but we do know that they like to be near squash and pumpkin vines. Once she's found a good spot, she'll dig out a tunnel and put a little cell at the end of that tunnel. Then she'll go off to find some squash and pumpkin flowers. Once she's found those flowers and collected some pollen, she'll go back to her nest and deposit that pollen at the base of the cell. She'll keep doing this until she has enough pollen for one baby. Once she's done that, she'll lay a single egg on top of that pollen, cap off that cell, and never see that baby again. Instead, she'll start making a new tunnel and cell, provisioning it with pollen, and laying another egg. And she'll keep doing this until she dies at the end of the summer. But if we focus on that egg that she laid, you'll see that it hatches into a larva, which will eat up all of that pollen, and then overwinter as a pre-pupa in a papery cocoon. In the spring, that bee will pupate and eventually emerge as an adult in the early summer. And that whole process will start all over again. So, when you're walking around your crop field or in your garden, be sure to look around your squash and pumpkin plants for squash bee nests. The entrances will be about the diameter of a pen or a pencil, and you may even be lucky enough to see a female entering the nest. Or, if you're digging around, you might find one of their papery cocoons, although these can be buried as deep as 18 inches, which is about 46 centimeters. And of course, you'll want to look for the bees themselves in your squash and pumpkin flowers. And if you don't know what you're looking for, you might confuse them with a honeybee, so be sure to watch our video on squash bee identification. Thanks for listening, and keep planting squash and pumpkin and supporting our amazing native bees. Funding for this video was provided by the Western Sustainable Agriculture Research and Education Program and the National Science Foundation's Graduate Student Research Fellowship Program. Additional support was provided by the Department of Entomology at the University of California in Davis.